All right, hi everyone. I'm Kelli from Little Apple Pilates, and welcome to Yoga Sculpt. So today if you have weights, you can go ahead and grab them, but if you don't, you can just go ahead and do the motions as we're going through class. You'll still get a great workout with or without weights. And yeah, if you guys can't hear my music or have trouble hearing me, let me know through the chat or anything. And if you guys are ready, let's go ahead and get started in child's pose. So let me play my music. All right, so go ahead and bring your big toes to touch. Bring your knees to the wide edges of your mat. Walk your hands to the front of your mat and rest your forehead all the way down. Starting to really sink your hips deeper into the pose. And relax here. Take some deep breaths. Maybe reach your hands a little higher. Spread your fingertips a little wider. Maybe rock your forehead side to side, massaging out your third eye center. Just take a minute here for yourself. A couple more breaths here. On your next inhale, slowly rise up to tabletop position, stacking shoulders over wrists, hips over knees. Inhale, cow pose, drop your belly, gaze comes forward. And exhale, cat pose, arch your spine towards the ceiling. Inhale, cow pose, drop your belly, and exhale, cat pose. Go ahead and make your way through this on your own, taking any other movements your body might need. Option for thread the needle. Almost come back to neutral spine when you're ready. Now tuck your toes, send your hips back and up for downward facing dog, excuse me. Maybe start to pedal out your legs here, pushing your chest towards your thighs. Couple more breaths here. Now slowly look forward between your hands, lift your heels, baby step your feet to meet your hands at the top of your mat. Spread your feet wide and go ahead and reach opposite hand to opposite elbows and hang heavy here for ragdoll pose. So maybe rocking side to side. Feeling the stretch in the back of your legs here. Now exhale, drizzle your fingertips down to the mat. Toe heel your feet to touch. Inhale, halfway lift. So hands come to knees, shins, or thighs. Neutral spine here. Gaze is down. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, mountain pose, so all the way up to standing. Arms up and overhead, feet are about hip width distance apart. Pinkies are dialed in, relax your shoulders. Now exhale, baby back bend, so cactus your arms out wide, gaze comes up. Inhale, back to mountain, exhale, side bend. Bring your right arm back, left arm forward. Inhale back to mountain. Exhale, other side. Left arm back, right arm forward. And inhale back to mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Hands through heart center all the way down to your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, high plank and hold. So stacking shoulders over wrists. Puff up the space between your shoulder blades. Inhale, hinge forward 1 to 2 inches. Lower down, bend your elbows to low plank. Immediately into upward facing dog. Tops of your toes, shining your chest forward, lifting your thighs above the ground if you can. And exhale, downward facing dog. So that's Chaturanga Dandasana. We'll do that a couple times throughout class. An option to skip it all together and meet in downward facing dog. So inhale, lift your heels, gaze comes forward. Exhale, step, hop, or float to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. So different here. Inhale, chair pose. Sit back, arms are up above your head, like you're about to sit in a chair. Engage your core here. And exhale, chair plane. Bring your arms back. And we're gonna pulse our triceps here. So just pulse tiny movements up. Starting to warm up our muscles. Four, three, two, one. Palms face each other now and pulse in and out. Just in and out. We got it. Four, three, two, one. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, forward fold. Hands through heart center. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, meet me in downward facing dog. Pushing your chest towards your thighs. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Exhale, step through low lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge. So all 10 toes are facing forward. Square your hips to the front. Arms are up and overhead. Exhale, warrior two. Spin open, check your heel to arch alignment. Arms are out to a T. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Front arm comes up and overhead. Little to no weight on your back hand. Exhale, cartwheel your arms down to that high to low plank. Chaturanga Dandasana, your variation to downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, step through low lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge, rise up. Palms face each other, relax your shoulders. Exhale, warrior two, open up. Check your heel to arch alignment, arms out to a T. Inhale, reverse your warrior, front arm comes up and overhead. Exhale, cartwheel your arms down to the mat, high to low plank, Chaturanga Dandasana. Your variation. From your down dog, shift your way forward to a high plank. We have plank tap out, so right and left. And left. Just like that. Firing up our core. Spread your fingertips out wide. Keep breathing here. Four, three, two, one. Go ahead and drop down to your knees. Grab some water, wipe some sweat if you need to. We have push-ups and we're gonna do some arm workouts next. So again, if you have weights, you can grab them, but if not, you're fine. So we're gonna start with traditional wide arm push-ups. So option for knees or toes. So spread your hands out wide and exhale, lower and lift. Lower, lift. Exhale at the top of your push-up. You got it. Your knees are there if you need them. And four, three, two, and one. Take a quick child's pose if you need to. Now if you have weights, you can go ahead and grab them, but if not, just do the motion. So we're gonna do bicep curls, wide waitress curls. So they're out wide, lift and lower. Lift, lower. So again, just do the motion without weights if you don't have any, or if you have something else in place of it, that's fine too. One arm at a time if you want. We got this. Four, just three, two, and one. Go ahead and ditch your weights if you have them. Second set of push-ups. Again, knees or toes. Palms out wide. Strong, tight core. Lower and lift. Almost there. Four, three, two, one. Again, child pose if you need it. Second set of arms. Grab your weights if you have them. We're gonna do a lateral lift into a hammerhead curl. So take this as slow as you need to go. Try on the lateral lift not to go above shoulder height. Keep a tight core here. We're almost there. Four. Three. Final two. And last one. Nice job. Go ahead and ditch your weights if you have them and come to standing at the top of your mat when you're ready. We have squats next. So we're gonna start with traditional squats. So legs, feet are about hip width distance apart. And lower, lift, lower, and lift. Squeezing your glutes at the top of your squat. If you have weights, you can keep them at heart center. So strong. Last four, three, hold low and two, one. Hold low and pulse. Small movements here, up and down. Not here for long. Four, three, two, and one. Kick out your legs. Grab a little water if you need to. All right, now we're going to do a curtsy squat. So bring your right foot forward. Your left foot comes kind of right, behind it, a little angled. We're going to lower and lift. Lower, lift. Right here. Option to grab weights if you want. four, three, two, one. Not quite done yet. So we're gonna go from curtsy squat to knee up. Curtsy squat, up. Kind of testing your balance a little bit here. If you have weights, option to add a bicep curl. Take these kind of slow to test your balance, test your core strength. Four, three, two, and one. Nice job. Kick out your legs a bit. Whew, I'm feeling it. All right, second side. So left leg, left foot is forward, right foot is back. So traditional curtsy squats first. Lower and lift. Lower, lift. Exhale the top of your squat. Almost there. Four, three, two, one. As you know, we're not done. So lower, and then into a knee, a high knee. Add the bicep curl if you want, or do the motion. You got it. Four. Three. Final two. Your best two. One. Oh, shake out your legs. Grab some water. One more set of squats. All right. When you're ready, spread your feet out wide, almost at an angle. We have forced squats, so lower and lift. Lower and lift. Send your glutes back, squeeze them at the top. Keep going. This is it for squats. Four, three, two, and one. Nice job, everyone. Kick out your legs. Grab some water. We do have cardio next, our favorite. All right. So we're gonna start, when you're ready, with a jump rope. So just jumping up and down. If you want to step it out, if you want to do some double jumps, whatever you want to do here, get our heart rates up. All right, we're going to do a couple different cardio exercises. So four, three, jumping jacks in two, and one, jumping jacks out and in. Step it out if you need to, catch your breath, but you got this. Out and in. Right here with you. You are strong. Mind over matter. Four, three, butt kickers in two, and one, butt kickers. Option to engage the arms, driving your heel into your glute, engaging your core here. We're almost there. Two more exercises after this. Burn in our calories. Four, three, ballerina squats in two, one. So ballerina squats, you're gonna jump, squat, jump, and squat. Feet come together, one in front of the other, then switch. Almost there, I promise. Four, three, two, toe taps in, one. So just up and up, up and up. Rotating legs. Engage the arms again. This is it. Keep breathing, let some of that heat out. Four, three, two, and one. You made it. Nice job. Grab some water. Kick out your legs. Whew. Nice job, everyone. All right. Whenever you're ready, take your time. We're gonna meet in downward facing dog. If you're using weights in your practice, have them nearby. All right, so take your time getting here. Now inhale, lift your right leg high, and exhale, step through, low lunge. Inhale, rise up, crescent lunge. So we're going to move into lunges. So if you want to have your weights, you can. So lower, lift if you want, chest fly, and lift. So just up and down for your lunges. Give this side the same amount of love. We got it. So strong. Just four, three, two. Last one. From your crescent lunge. Sorry, I have to keep moving around. Exhale, warrior two. Spin open. Bend that front knee. Inhale, sculpt star. So rise up. Legs are out wide. Exhale, horse. Sit low. Now bring your elbows wide behind your head. We have seesaw. So dip back, center, front, center. Feel it in your obliques. We got it. Four, three, two, one. Inhale, sculpt star. Feel the release. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior for arm up and overhead. Exhale, chaturanga dandasana, high to low plank. Your variation. Take what you need here. From your down dog, shift forward to a high plank. 20 seconds of mountain climbers, fast or slow. 20 seconds here. You got it, push it. Keep breathing. Four, three, two, one. Drop down to your knees. Nice job, grab water. All right, make your way down to your back. When you're ready. All right, bend your knees. So we have hip lifts first. So hands down by your sides. Lift, load. Lift and load. Squeezing our glutes at the top of our hip lift. Tight core. Feel your muscles working hard. And four, hold high in three, two, hold high. So we have marches now. So right and left, bending your knee, bringing your knee towards your chest, keeping your foot flexed and your glutes high. Squeeze your glutes, we're almost there. Four, three, full range in two, one, lower and lift. Lower, lift. Not here for long. Four, hold high, three, just two, one. Hold high, bringing your knees together and out. Together, out, this is it. Keep breathing. Four, three, two, one. Lower all the way down. Give your knees, bring them into your chest, give them a squeeze. We have core next. So, we're gonna start with a basic crunch. So bringing your elbows out wide and just up and down. Nice and easy here. Feel it in your core. Let it do the work. We got this. You got this. And four, three, two, one. Come on down. We have, or we're gonna come to reverse tabletop, so bend your knees. Arms are going to come up. Now you're going to lower opposite leg with opposite arm and back to tabletop. So opposite arm and opposite leg, lowering and lifting. Keep going here. Last four, three, two, one. Hold high. We're going to do all four lower and lift. Lower, lift. Kind of challenging our core here, pushing our bodies to the limit. Take this as slow as you need. We're almost there. We'll cool it down after this. Just four. Three, two, and one. Lower all the way down. Give yourself a minute. Let your heart rate come down. Take a couple breaths here. Inhaling, fill up, and exhaling, letting it all go. When you're ready, go ahead and bring your knees into your chest for a squeeze. Now let your right leg go long. Guide your left knee across your body for supine twist, keeping both shoulder blades on the ground. Just relaxing here. More breaths. Now bring both of your knees back into your chest. Give yourself a squeeze to reset your spine. Now let your left leg go long and guide your right knee across your body. Inhaling to lengthen, exhaling to deepen the stretch. Now slowly bring your knees back into your chest. Now happy baby pose is next. Reach for your inner or outer parts of your feet. Bend your knees and go ahead and rock side to side, massaging out your low spine. Maybe stretching one leg, then the other. Kind of taking what you need here. Just relaxing here. Now when you're ready, go ahead and bring your knees into your chest. And your release is final Shavasana. So take up as much or as little space as you like. We're just going to take a couple of deep breaths here. Deep belly breaths, inhaling, filling all the way up, and exhaling, letting it all go. Whatever you're holding on to, what's stressed, just let it go. Thanking ourselves for making it to our mats today. Now slowly reach your arms up and overhead for a full body stretch, like you're just waking up for the first time today. And go ahead and roll over onto your right or your left side for supported fetal position, using your bicep as a pillow. Just rest here for a moment. And when you're ready, go ahead and come up to a seated position for easy pose. Crossing your legs, relaxing your shoulders, maybe stretching out your neck. Now I want you to reach your right arm behind your back and your left arm on your knee and twist. And in exhale, back to center. Now your left arm, come back. And exhale, back to center. So we're gonna bring our hands to heart center. We're gonna do one more breath here together. So inhale, fill up your lungs. And audible exhale. Let it all go. So the light and love in me honors and respects the light and love in each and every one of you. Bringing your hands to our third eye center and bowing forward to seal our practice. Namaste.